Okay, so you guys know I've been playing a little bit of Atlas recently. Now, the reason I want to do this is because Ryan has played a ton of Ark. I'm not an Ark expert. Ryan hasn't played Atlas yet, right?
No, I haven't played Atlas yet, but I did look at my Steam details, and I have played Ark for 257 hours.
Yeah, so he knows all
I know about
Ark.
It.
So when I started playing Atlas, everybody was yelling at me, and they're saying, Mike, why are you even playing this? This is just a reskinned Ark. Yeah. And I'm like, oh, well, I don't really know Ark that well, so I'm just going to try this, whatever. I like pirate-themed stuff. I've lived into that kind of thing. And I do like the idea of like a MMO with a lot of people playing, and you can be pirates and doing piratey things. Like, I think that's a cool idea, which is why I wanted to play Sea of Thieves. I played a lot of Sea of Thieves with, you know, Paul.
Right.
And we did some streams. I ended up not liking the game, but I tried it. I wanted a pirate thing. So I see the trailer for Atlas. I'm like, ooh, another MMO. Ooh, pirates. I'll try it out.
Okay.
I start playing the game. And first thing is the game spawns me in the middle of the ocean. That's how it starts out. And I'm like, okay, is this how it's supposed to be? So I'm swimming around. I'm going around. It just goes on for a long time. I grab like a chicken in the water. Like, I don't know what the hell I'm doing. And it took me like, I don't know, 20 minutes or something just to get to land.
Okay.
And finally, I get to land. I'm learning the basics of how to play the game and whatnot. So this goes on for a long time. And what I found out is the game had just launched. So there was a lot of things broken with it. So I had spawned in a location that they hadn't finished. So I was like, okay, I'll go to a different server and I'll spawn in a better location. So I spent a little while going to different servers trying to find a good place to go. Finally, I find a really good location. And I'm like, okay, now I'm on land. I'm doing the things you're supposed to do. And one of the things you're supposed to do is like get a hatchet, which is probably like in Ark.
Yeah, it's like one of the first things you do in Ark.
Right, because it's a reskinned Ark. So I'm starting to just do the basic things. I end up finally making like an axe, and like I finally chop down a tree, and I start getting materials, and then something comes along and kills me, and I'm like, great, I just spent like an hour doing that. So I load up a new server. And I'm like, forget that island, let me try and find an easier island. So I find an easier island. I start playing the game, and same thing. I'm like, okay, I found a great island. I made my first hatchet.
Okay.
I made a pick. I did all the things I'm supposed to do. I start making progress, and the game crashed on me. Oh my god, I think the game just locked up. Did the game just fucking lock up? You motherfucker! Okay, let me ask you a question. In Ark, if you want to eat food and stay alive, what are the things you have to do to stay alive,
So Ark only has two things. Well, it only has two things, but then there's two things that affect them.
Okay.
There's food and there's water.
Okay.
And if you are too cold, your food goes down super fast.
Right.
Unless you put your level up points into something called resilience.
Okay.
If you are too hot, your water goes down super fast. Unless you put points in the resilience.
So in this game, they added vitamins.
Okay.
So on top of having your food and your water, you have to maintain like your vitamin A, whatever, B, C, D, or whatever, all your different vitamins. So if you are eating too many berries, let's say, you have too much. What happened to me is I had too much vitamin A and I died because I had too much
vitamin A poisoning.
Vitamin A poisoning and I died. So that's one thing. But you had just mentioned in Ark, you can freeze if you don't have, you know, the right armor or whatever, all the stuff that you're wearing. I was playing this game, so I'm like, okay, same thing. I'm freezing. It's too cold out. So I'm trying to do whatever I can to get, like, fur and get all that stuff. But it took me so long to gather materials. Now, I played Ark with you. Ark, you were saying that's kind of broken too, but it's not broken to this level.
So our, just so you know, the server that we play Ark on, I have the resources set to be like triple what they would normally be.
Okay.
But that's because I have a life. You similarly, you should play, like, really, I think if we play Atlas, number one, we shouldn't play Atlas for like a year.
No, yeah.
Because like if you're spawning in like the water with a chicken and like it's not good.
Yeah.
Number two, if you're not making it like your vocation in life, like playing Ark on live servers is a little bit like getting a part-time job. Yeah. You should probably play, like you can play.
I have to vary it up.
You play it with some friends. You go to the server. You set like the resources higher, you set like
but so that kind of stuff. So speaking of resources, so I spend hours on this island, and this is the, by the way, this is now the second stream that I'm playing it. So I found an island that's pretty good. I'm in better shape. I got my stuff, and I'm going around, and now again I'm trying to make like boots or whatever for myself. So I needed like three things. I needed like, I forget what it was, like wheat and cotton and some other thing. I got the two things, but I'm going around the whole island trying to find, it wasn't wheat, it was like thatch or whatever.
Probably thatch, because that's in.
Or cotton or something. Let's just say it's like cotton. So I'm going around for like 2 hours trying to find cotton so that I can not be cold. So there was a dude in the chat, and what we found out is that the game was bugged and there was no cotton. There was no cotton on that island. Wow. And it was actually a thing in like a forum. People were like, this part of the game is like bugged. So I was playing the game for 2 hours and there was no chance that I could play. I want to tell you one more thing about this game that happened to me. The second time I played the game spawned me at the bottom of the ocean.
Wow.
So it wasn't just, by the way, it wasn't just me that I'm an idiot.
It was everybody.
There was like 100 people down there. And they're all swimming around, and they're getting attacked by like octopuses and whatever the fuck. And it's just like, I'm just like, it's like the worst. It's the worst piece of shit. I think the best reason to play the game, I think that if they just kept the game just like this, maybe keep making updates, but don't improve the game. I think that this is one of the worst games ever made, but I do think that it's one of the best streaming games ever made, because it gave me more to talk about and make fun of.
So like, what do you think about developers releasing games where they're like, it'll be done at some point?
You know what I'm going to say. It's like, back in my day.
Back in my day, they didn't do that. Like, it's kind of funny. Like, the game that we're working on has, right now, we're working on a couple bugs that are, you probably would never find them in a regular playthrough.
Not these kind of huge bugs.
Right. It's not like, oh, you teleport through the wall. It's like, if you're on like level 7 and you jump a certain way and like you run into problems, like,
Those are the kind of bugs that you're, you know, people had been saying to me, like Link to the Past.
Yeah.
I said like, well, back in our day, our games didn't have bugs. And somebody's like, well, in Link to the Past, there actually is a bug. But it's like, there's a little teeny bug, but it's not like the game, they release a game that's completely fucking broken.
Right. And for money, like a lot of money.
That I paid for this game. And the game's completely broken, and now they, in this day and age, I mean, this is just how it is now, but, like, they expect the people to figure out all the problems with the game, as opposed to back then, they had, they finished the fucking game.
Yeah, exactly, but, I mean, that being said, AAA development is super hard, and, you know, they're making, like, a top-tier game, right? And they're like a little company. I mean, they're not an indie company, but they're a little company. Okay. Like, these things cost money, you know?
Sure.
But, I mean, people are having fun, right? That's the point of a game. At least they're not loot boxing you to death.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, like, there's,
I was having fun in the fact that it was so broken that, kind of like when I played Superman 64.
Yeah.
It's like I had fun because it's so broken. I stand there until they're dead. Oh, and look, it disappeared!
Oh my god.
Look at that horse down there. I think I had fun because I was streaming it and I was able to like make fun of it with people.
Yeah.
But if I bought this game and I was playing it by myself, I think I would have just been pissed.
You went into something messed up?
Yeah.
You're making me want to play it just so I could see like what messed up.
It's hilariously
messed
broken.
Up.
It's hilariously
things happen.
Yeah. I actually kind of want to play it more just because it makes me laugh. So I got up to level 8, but they block you at level 8 and you can't get any more experience after that point, because at that point you have to build a raft and leave and go do something else before you can get more experience.
That's cool.
Except for the fact that if you're playing by yourself, it's like next to, and also on top of the game being like totally bugged and shit, it's like impossible to build a raft. Like, you're talking about building a raft. Maybe if you have a bunch of friends, you can do it. I could barely build a pick, let alone build a fucking raft.
Right.
And get off the island. Like, that would be like beating the game for me to build a fucking raft.
Yeah.
And that's like, where are the pirates? You know?
You're a pirate. You're just a bad one.
Yeah.
Right? So here's what we're going to do.
Yeah.
Here's how we're going to make Atlas great again.
Okay.
I got to fix Paul's computer so I can run it. that's not for you, but that's all I gotta do.
Yeah. Paul said he wanted to play it.
Yeah, so I'm gonna fix Paul's computer so he can run it. I'm going to get it for us, and the three of us will build a raft and we will go for it.
If you can get me onto a goddamn pirate ship.
Dude, I will get you. We are going to be the most piratical motherfuckers you've ever seen.
Because
don't you worry.
Because let me get to the point of what I want to have happen. Okay. What I want to happen is I want to be on a ship, a pirate ship. That's our ship.
Yeah.
We're fucking pirates. And I want to find another pirate ship
and blow it up.
And I want to blow it up and I want to take your fucking treasure.
Sure. Like, that's what like I wanted, a good pirate.
Like it would be in Sea of Thieves if Sea of Thieves, if it didn't suck.
I think, like, look out. Like, Atlas, if people keep playing it and they manage to be able to build up a new thing, like this game could be great in a few months.
Yeah, if they keep patching it, that's my hope for it. Like Sea of Thieves, I feel like they kind of gave up on it.
Yeah.
Hopefully they don't give up on one of these. Like, if they keep fixing it, maybe it'll be good.
Maybe it'll be good.
So
I don't know. So despite that, you want people to check it out?
I want people to check the game out?
Yeah, or no?
If you want to laugh at something that's broken, check it out. If you want to, like, play a good game, don't play Atlas.
Yeah.
Not yet, at least.
Play Ark.
Play Ark. Yeah.
Okay, but like, do it on a private server with friends.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's that.
Thanks for watching.